say that I'd never felt this way.
Don't you love those pictures?
I do.
February is the month of love, and the love is continuing in the kitchen today. Lara Brooke is here. She is a certified nutritionist, and she says just because maybe you're cutting back after being a little bit naughty over the Valentine's Day holiday, it doesn't mean you can't have something sweet that's actually good for you.
Exactly. And I think that chocolate should be part of our daily life.
That sentiment. I think we'd all agree with you.
Exactly.
We're making a low-fat chocolate brownie. And I feel like some people say low-fat. Is it?
Oh no, this tastes so divine. It's so good. And not only is it low fat, but it's actually good for you.
Oh good.
So
okay.
It's really good. So
look at the finished product with that whipped cream and the chocolate on there. Reagan tried to eat some a little bit earlier and we had to say, Reagan, we need that to show on camera.
It's very delicious.
What should we put in first?
Okay, so first we have, this is so easy. We just put everything in at once and then mix it. So we're going to start with 1.5 cups of oat flour. We can go ahead and add that.
Now, why oat flour?
Oat flour is a whole grain carbohydrate. It's actually a good carbohydrate, and I substitute oat flour instead of regular refined flour, which is much, much better for you.
Do you ever do half and half, or it's fine to just do the oat?
I do. I do. It makes it a little bit more flaky, so you want to mix it with something that does have some gluten in it, which is right here, and mm-hmm. that is 1.5 cups of spelt flour. Spelt flour actually is higher in protein and B vitamins than regular flour.
Are these easy to find just in your grocery store?
Yeah. Okay. And most health food stores have them. So the next thing is, let's go ahead and add the applesauce. We've got 1 cup of applesauce, and this is unsweetened applesauce.
Is this instead of the butter?
Yes. Okay. Instead of butter and the oil.
Yeah. Unsweetened applesauce.
Mm-hmm. All right. So it doesn't have any sugar. And the nice thing is you don't even know the difference. When you get applesauce, it's just unsweetened. It tastes just as good as stuff with sugar.
It makes it so moist, too. I feel like you've put this in cookies before. When
you've
been on the show.
Yes.
They're so moist.
Yeah, it's so easy. And then we've got 4 egg whites, which, of course, cuts the fat. And we go ahead and add
that. Put those in there? Okay.
Yep. And then we have 2 eggs, because yolk is good for you, in moderation, right? So go ahead and add that. Then we've got 2 teaspoons of vanilla.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to just add that right to it. And we've got 3 cups of low glycemic fructose, and this is our sweetener, instead of sugar. It's a lower glycemic. So you still want to do portion control. You don't want to, you know, eat 10 of them, but it allows you to have that lower glycemic.
So not half and half, but the whole thing, the lower glycemic. Where do you pick this up?
You can get it at health food stores. You can also get it at most grocery stores,
really?
Too.
Okay.
Yeah. And it works just like sugar. You can use it just in place of sugar.
Put that
so
in there.
And then the last is we have 1 cup of cocoa powder, and this is just regular baking cocoa.
And that's a good amount of cocoa.
Oh, I love
mean,
it.
That's these are going to be nice and chocolatey.
That is what we love. So then, let's see, we've got everything in. We're going to go ahead and lift this up and just mix it until it is just blended.
I know you have kids at your house. What do they think about these low-fat things?
They love them. They love them. In fact, my brother-in-law, he's really not into health at all. I made these at Thanksgiving time, and he had it, and he said, those are really good. And I told him, yeah, they're actually good for you. And he said, no, they're really good.
When you can't tell the difference, you know you've done something right.
I know, exactly. So we'll just turn this off and then scrape the sides.
Okay.
Just to make sure we've got all the powder released there.
You have one of these in your kitchen, so you know your way around a KitchenAid.
Yes, and I have 4 girls, and my little daughter Emma is watching right now. So hi, Emma.
Hi, Emma. How old is Emma?
She's 3.
She's 3.
Yes.
Okay, Emma, we're going to save you a brownie.
She'll be very excited about that.
Reagan's here.
Maybe
I'll
not.
Try to save you a brownie, Emma.
Exactly. The nice thing about this is we've got high antioxidant cocoa. We're going to just mix this up just a little bit more. So these brownies are actually very, very high in antioxidants. Not only low fat, but high in antioxidants.
You're eating chocolate and it's good for you.
It's like a vegetable. Cocoa, did you know that cocoa is actually a vegetable?
I didn't, but I'm going to write that down.
And it grows on trees.
Remember that.
So that is, let's turn it up
just
a little bit.
That's it. It just gets kind of creamy in there in the KitchenAid as you mix.
And then we'll just release this down.
Is that it? You just put it all in one bowl, stir it up, and
I am so
pour it in the
about
pan.
It has to be easy or it's not going to happen for me.
Your pan is greased. Your glass
it is.
Dish.
I sprayed that with Pam's spray, and I'm just going to add this. And it looks like we've done pretty good here. I'm just going to add this, and then this is the yummy part. We're going to take some Xocai nuggets, which are very, very high in antioxidants. And I've got some crushed.
Now, what are they called?
They're called Xocai, and it's spelled X-O-C-A-I. And it's actually made with raw cocoa. So
really?
It's actually very delicious
and
high.
Is this a dark chocolate?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And it's very, very high in antioxidants. So we're going to take, well, to give you an idea, one nugget has the equivalent of 12 ounces of spinach in antioxidants.
Are you kidding?
And it's chocolate.
My daughter's thrilled. She's like, put those chocolates on my plate instead of the spinach.
I have to hide them from
Emma.
Do
you?
So,
where do you get them?
You can get them through independent distributors.
Okay.
You can also email me and reach my website, which is laurabrook.com with an E.
Laurabrook.com.
And then
we'll link you from our website a little bit later today, everybody, abc4.com. If you want to find these, spell them again.
Xocai.
Xocai. Okay, are we putting these on before
we are, yes. We're going to put them, let's go ahead and put it on.
Just sprinkle?
Yep, sprinkle it kind of evenly throughout.
Okay.
And then what I'm going to do is just stir it just so that it's just at the very top layer, but still covered.
Are these going to melt?
Oh, it's so divine. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
And it's so good for you. That's the thing.
Whoops.
That's okay.
Whoops.
We'll look that up later.
All right.
So we just make sure that it's all evenly coated. And basically all that you do is you put it in the oven at 350 degrees for about 30 minutes, and they come out just delicious. And you don't want to overbake it because it gets a little dry when you overbake it.
Make sure you are watching. Mm-hmm. 30 minutes only.
And then
you put berries on yours.
Yes.
It's a whipped cream.
And it adds the antioxidants. And then I sprinkle some more of the Xocai chocolate on. And the Xocai chocolate will help you lose weight.
Okay,
it decreases your sugar cravings.
Reagan, Marty, do you ladies need a bite of something that'll help you lose weight and it tastes good? Well, they're coming in here. ABC4.com, everybody, is where you get this recipe online, the delicious low-fat brownies. Or you can call our recipe hotline, 975-4443. Press 2 for recipes, and you can have Laura Brooks yummy brownies.
I've been waiting.
Here you go, Nate.
I think it's almost been torture. I've been waiting for 49 minutes.
You're going to love them.
Are they moist?
Oh,
is it divine?
Fat?
Yeah.
That does not taste low fat.
Mm. rich with antioxidants.
Yummy.
It's so good
for
you.
In fact, this bite, I'm going to lose 5 pounds.
So good for you.
Just by chewing.
You won't want to eat any other chocolate.
You know, I love the fruit on brownies.
Isn't
I haven't done that
so
before.
So good.
That's delicious. Laura, thank you.
You're so
much.
Welcome.
Here. Up next, everybody, do you know how to crackle? It's a really cool technique, and Roberts is going to show us how.
Please love them.
This was such a good idea.
Utah is always looking for delicious home cooking recipes, so email your mouth-watering recipes to goodthings@abc4.com. Supplies for our home cooking recipes provided by Albertsons.